Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to be in your midst today and to inaugurate the seminar on the changing role of women in India. In view of my various other engagements, I was till the last moment not sure whether I would be able to make it to this elite gathering. But it is my good fortune that I am able to be here and address you all. The above subject is not a new one to anybody. We all have along sympathized with women. We have given women a very high place both in the family and the society. Our ancestors have given the foremost place to women in family, and that is how the mother is considered first below the father, teacher, and the god. However, in recent times, maybe for the past 4 or 5 decades, women have not been given their due in the society. They have been relegated to a secondary role, and men have been considered superior. The main reason for this, girls were not admitted to schools and very largely trained to be housemakers. We should not forget here that a woman, whether she is a housewife or a teacher or any other, has always guided the family and the society to a large extent. Gandhiji had advocated that women should be given equal status to that of men, and his one dream was to see that every girl child is educated. Though he is not with us today, his dream has come true partly under the governments, both at the center and the states, are making all out efforts to provide full opportunities so that every girl child is educated, whether she is in a village or town. It may not be out of place here to mention that in addition to the opportunities being provided to the girl child, the central government has been promoting the spread of literacy among the illiterate women. Through the National Literacy Movement and the Operation Blackboard and the various other schemes. Though one may argue that these schemes are not solely aimed at educating women rather than the men who are mostly making use of these schemes. Today, after 4 decades of sustained efforts by the government, 80% of Indian women are educated. One can see women today competing equally with men in many fields. Women today are even not thinking twice before offering their services to the defense forces. Recently, a batch of 30 women pilots passed out of the Air Force Training Academy. Participation of women in public life is not new. More recently, women have come out to represent the people, and we can find many lady members in parliament and state legislatures. There are many women entrepreneurs who have established and are running big industries. Let us all who have gathered here take a pledge that we will fight tooth and nail against all women atrocities. If each and every one of us fight for equal status to them, then I am sure the position of women would improve. Basically, an Indian woman is yet to change. I have expressed my views as a layman. There are experts who would throw more light on this subject. While I invite those experts on to the dais, I heartily thank you all for giving me patient hearing. Dear sir, we are sorry to receive your letter of the 6th September expressing your dissatisfaction with the results of the color printing of your clothes. We must, however, disclaim the responsibility if you examine the conditions of the acceptance which are printed on the back of all receipts and displayed in each of our branches, you will see that we cannot guarantee the results of coloring the clothes, as so much depends upon the quality of the clothes. Also, there are no so many excellent imitation on the market that often customers are under the impression that the ready-made clothes are genuine clothes. In fact, they are not. Nevertheless, we do accept the responsibility if the damage is caused due to negligence on the part of our staff. We have examined your clothes and find that they were quite old clothes. We have seen a copy of the receipt which was handed to you, on which there is a note to the effect that the clothes were excessively soiled. When such a note is made, our assistants are free to draw the attention of the customer to it and inform the customers that we cannot guarantee results. If you wish, we will endeavor to remove the whitish marks on the clothes of which you complain, but we cannot promise the success. If you desire, the work will be carried out at your own risk. Thanking you, yours faithfully.